last year, but it's a little dull. It's not shaving sharp at all. So without further ado, we're going to go to Kyle for a quick demonstration.
Here on the sharpener, so I can set the edge angle to any angle between 10 and 35 degrees. Is there a preferred angle on this knife that you want?
Well, what would you prefer? Looking at this, guys, this is just a typical, never touched Topps Cub knife, I do believe. Just go with whatever you think will work good on it.
I'll give you a 25. For a knife like this, it'll give you an incredibly sharp edge, but it'll also have really good edge retention. So it'll take a good beating and hold an edge while you're out in the field.
All right. Now guys, these work wonderful for people who don't know necessarily what they're doing with a whetstone, or maybe just don't have the time to.
On the 120 grit drew a really nice burr, so that's my indicator I'm ready to go to the next grit. So now we'll go up to a 65 micron belt, that's about a 220 grit, and we'll start refining the edge.
Now as he finishes this up, I want y'all to know just how quickly he changed the belt on this machine. He can change it faster than I have literally said it. That was probably about 6 seconds to change from a coarse to a much finer belt. He's going to work his way down as he works the material into a sharper and finer edge. Whetstone that fast. That just makes this tool amazing to me. And you can already see the reflective surface on that blade just polished.
All right, one more to go. We're going to finish up on the 12,000 grit. It's about the equivalent of a leather strop.
Up on this blade right here. See if we can even show you. First things you'll notice is the shine. Next, little manscaping challenge. The hair is just flying off.
A lot faster than a stone.
All right, well, Kyle did a great job. I cannot brag enough. We have to work a while trying to grow all the hair back just from testing it.
So more than me.